It's the perfect complement to cocktails on the deck or on the patio or as an appetizer before dinner.
Or sometimes just dinner.
Mm-hmm. It's something even someone with zero kitchen skills can create. Here to show us how to create the perfect summer cheese board, food and dining editor from Minneapolis St. Paul Magazine, Stephanie March. Good morning, Stephanie.
Yay. Good morning. I love cheese for dinner. I'm not going to lie. There's like some hot August days where it's like, am I going to turn the oven on or am I going to crack a little wine and have a little
My
cheese?
Dinner last night consisted of fresh mozzarella and tomatoes. That's what I had on the deck.
That's beautiful.
Caprese, you missed the basil.
No, I put a little basil, a little Italian dressing little in there, too, a little salt.
Good fruity olive oil in there.
Yeah,
boom.
It was really good. You brought a cheese plate with you this morning.
I did.
What's going on here?
Because I think that, you know, with summer, people sometimes think like cheeses, you know, they think burgers and everything else, but I think there's a lot of great things that go with it. Burrata, we're going to start right up here with this lovely looking blob thing. Burrata is kind of the cheese of the season, and it goes really well with, obviously, tomatoes and basil. It's a step up from your fresh mozzarella.
Oh, okay. Okay. Burrata.
So what it is it's basically this lovely, you can see it looks like it's a little sort of pouch. Mm-hmm. It's got fresh ricotta inside.
No way.
The mozzarella. In fact, let's do a little cut.
Oh, even better. Confused.
I know. And it's so beautiful.
If you cut into it,
you can see the soft, gorgeous, fresh ricotta in there. And you can like slather it on a cracker, do whatever you want, or get some on your tomato basil. But this is an Italian cheese, and it's, you know, there's a lot of people who make it locally at cheese stores. But you find
this. Are we eating the outside?
Yeah, do it, the whole thing. Just put it on there, and it's just fresh and yummy, and a little olive oil again, and a little drizzle of salt and olive oil on there.
That tastes like summer.
It's fresh summer.
Want me to make you one?
No, I'm okay. I got more stuff to try.
You got other things,
I'm gonna keep eating.
And then fresh ricotta, which I didn't bring any fresh ricotta, but which is on the inside of that, which is so easy to make. I don't know, guys, if you guys have ever made this at home, but fresh ricotta is basically you take, you know, like a gallon of whole milk and a pint of buttermilk, and you kind of heat it slowly on the stove, and the curds separate, and all you have to do is drain it, and you have fresh ricotta.
I had no idea.
You are a cheesemaker. You could be a cheesemaker.
I just like to be
You're going
to
try
eater.
That next. You guys are going to try that next.
We did your green beans last week after you're here talking about grilling those green beans. Couldn't have been easier or better.
I know.
So now we're going to make cheese.
You're going to make cheese. I'm going to train you guys. If you can't make cheese, I'm going to show you this. This is my new favorite thing from Castello. This is a Danish blue cheese. And they have made them into these lovely, they call it the burger blue. And it's the perfect size for your burger. You know what I mean? Because sometimes when you get a crumbly blue cheese on your burger and
it
you're like,
it goes all over the place.
It goes all over and then it's like you bite and it crumbles out.
Right. Mm-hmm.
Right, and it just is not good. This is one of my new favorite things, and it just sits lovely and nicely on top of your burger. And if you want to do a Juicy Lucy and put
Folder it up.
In the burger, you can try that. That's next.
That is handy. We got a wedge. What's our wedge?
Okay, so this is, everybody loves a brie, right? Mm-hmm. LMR is a local cheese company. They're actually one of the best, and this is their Blue Earth Brie. And this is it's Blue Earth County, named after where it's made in Mankato. And this is one of the best bries that you're gonna find now, you guys. This is a lovely, soft, buttery brie. It's perfect for every kind of situation. You know, if you have people who are like, you know, I just don't go for those weird
real
cheeses.
Soft cheeses. Mm-hmm.
That's a gorgeous brie that you can totally pick up all the time.
And it's well regarded, isn't it?
Well regarded. It's really, you know, these guys, it's a well regarded brie.
Because
look at you throw down.
I know, look at that.
Got some cheese stories.
It's a well regarded cheese.
There you are. All right. Here, there's a brie.
No, I'm going to try that.
Who's on the brie? Brie's,
do you heat this up?
I do not, because I am a purist with brie. I think that you let the flavors kind of bloom. I like it room temperature. This is this is your sort of like your creaminess, and it's kind it's kind of an every, should be on every cheese plate.
Yeah, that's nice.
Just fills your whole mouth.
It does.
Great flavor.
It's 100%.
A little curds.
Yeah.
And a little curds. Those are Ellsworth cheese curds. You guys, you don't have to fry cheese curds. I don't know if you knew that or not.
Well, but they are really good that way.
I know, you can do that if you want.
Plain curds are awesome.
But they do chew up really nicely. They're just fun. They're kind of good. They're great on salads. Here's a little trick for you. Put a little keep them cold, then put a little olive oil on them, stick them right under the broiler for a few seconds. And they get this lovely they don't melt, they get this lovely little crisp top.
Hello.
And they're not rubbery.
That makes it nice. Now, are there any rules about picking cheeses when it comes to this stuff?
You know, I like to say, I like to hit sort of the quadrants, you know, where you have like a creamy, like a brie.
Right.
And you have like a solid, I usually pick a cheddar or something that's kind of a little bit more, you know, like a manchego, that's a harder cheese. And then I like a blue. Because I think a blue is always good. There's all those people who are like, you know, I want the big flavor.
That's
a Roquefort,
big flavor.
Maybe a Faribault Caves blue locally. And then I like to have the rogue cheese, the stinky cheese. I like a Red Hawk Creamery stinky, stinky cheese because they're the goods.
Of course you do.
You got to get past that stink and then that flavor is
Boom.
Just blossoms
Boom.
And grows.
Boom! Yeah.
Well, Stephanie,
love it.
Thank you very much. This is good stuff right here.
We're gonna do this.
Stephanie, as always, she's from the Minneapolis-St. Paul magazine. Thank you for this Friday.
You're welcome.
I like a good cheese board.
Cheesy cheese.